Hello everybody and welcome to another one of our videos. Today we're going to be talking a little bit about one of my favorite OSINT tools. OSINT, for those who don't know, is open source intelligence, which basically just means any intelligence or any data that is freely available on the internet. In Google, Facebook, Instagram, phone number databases like whitepages.com, information about domain names, a lot of different places that you can get that information. Maltego's goal is to make the collection and organization of this data easier. You'll see it used a lot by journalists, cybersecurity professionals that are doing investigations into breaches that have occurred, law enforcement. So let's go ahead and dig into a little bit. I'm not going to go super in-depth into each transform and what they do. I'll save that for some future videos because there's a lot that this encompasses, but I just want you to see the tool, kind of get used to what it is, how it works, and some of the ways that it's used. When you first launch Maltego, after you've gone through the setup and you've created an account, you'll need an account to get this created. So you'll need to tie it back to your email address and stuff like that. You'll see this page here, and it allows you to install what are called transforms. Transforms are basically just sources of information or places that you can pull data from. There's places like abuse.ch, abuse IP database, case files. I always install this one when I first started up. There's also a bunch of transforms that you can pay for. So if you're a user of Digital Shadows, for example, or if you're a Maltego subscriber, you can get access to some of this data. Right now we're on the Community Edition, which is the free version, but there are editions where you get some additional transforms that you can run and access to quite a bit more information as well. But for the purposes of this, I'm just showing you the tool, kind of some of the things it can be used for, and get you a little bit of a teaser into the power of how it works and what it can be used for. So this is what it looks like when you first start it up. But when you go ahead and press new and you launch a new graph, this is what you'll get. On the right hand side, you'll get a little graph. On the left hand side, you'll get a list of entities. And then you can basically just pull entities from the left onto the right, and you can also run those transforms that I was discussing to pull some of this information for you. So let's just say I'm looking for myself, information on myself. Very important when you run this that you run it against people that you have the authority, or you know, you have a very good reason to run this information on. It wouldn't be ethical to run this against random people. This needs to be something for a cybersecurity investigation, or a law enforcement investigation, or something of that matter. Just because something's legal to do doesn't mean that it's ethical to do. So with that disclaimer out of the way, let's go ahead and just type my name in here. I know my name, so I'll just put James Curtis. In a typical investigation, you might not have a lot of information to go on. So you might just have a name, you might have a website, you might have an IP address, phone number, email. You might have a few pieces of those information. So you might have a name and an email. So let's just say you had an email. You could grab that email and you could throw it on here and you could put that person's email in there. And then you can actually tie that email to that person. You can say this is James's email. So you get a nice little graphical representation of exactly how this data is connected. You get my name up here, the description of what it is because I labeled that link, and then the email address itself. You could right click on this email. You can do sticks to utilities. You can do hunter, have I been pwned? So you can actually go out and run, have I been pwned against this email address to see if it's been involved in any breaches. It's very useful to do investigations like this on yourself. I'm not going to run these because I don't want to accidentally pull up any information on myself that I wouldn't want other people to actually see. But you can see kind of the power of how this would be used. So if we ran this and it was my actual email, you could go ahead and run that, have I been pwned, and pull up all of the places that my email address has actually been breached at. And then you would be able to actually start pivoting. So if you were doing this as part of a penetration test, for example, you could put in a company, you could, maybe you have one user, you found one user and you know that this particular company uses firstname.lastname. @company.com. You could put that email in there, find out where they've been pwned, and you can start doing email campaigns against that. Again, very important only to do this in places you actually have authorization. Let's go ahead and look at some of the actual entities and some of the different things, and you'll kind of get a sense of some of the places or that this can be used. So you can pull in judges' names, you can pull in Bitcoin addresses, Dogecoin transactions, Ethereum transactions, mobile computers, smartphones. So you could say, hey, I know that James has a smartphone. You could put the brand of smartphone in. You could say James has an HTC. You can tie that back. You can say James's phone. And then press OK. Now you've got that bit of information there as well. This becomes really powerful when we start tying these back to transforms. So the ability to actually run some of this information. You won't get all of your information in here. You'll still have to go out to Google and do things like type in phone numbers and do some manual hunting. But even if you're doing manual hunting, you can still go ahead and tie that back to these entities. So once you've found that information, you can pull that in here as well. But there are a ton of different transforms that can pull in some of this data in an automated fashion, which is what it's really great for as well. You can see there's something for almost everything: religious groups, political movements, IPv4 addresses, ports, websites, SSL certificates, Shodan. That's another great one. So you can actually tie this back to your Shodan API, and you can pull in information from IP addresses or IP CIDR blocks. So you can actually run those queries straight from Maltego. So you're not pivoting back and forth between so many different places. You can pull in geographic location like city, GPS coordinates, your home, office, prison. So you start to get a sense for kind of the type of things that this would be used for: criminal investigations, malware forensics, so malware investigations. You can pull in hashes, children, youth, drug dealer, gang member, all sorts of different things that you can pull in, military officers, terrorist leader. Definitely this is very much used by law enforcement, but also government as well, doing open source investigations and pulling in. They can even pull in their own data sources from Splunk, or you can pull in, you can create your own transforms as well to pull back information and lots of great things as well. So this is really just a very introductory kind of look at Maltego and what it does. Later on, we'll probably go through an actual investigation where we run through some of these transforms, but I just wanted to give a very introductory look at Maltego and what it was and what you might use it for. If you guys want to see more videos like this, please like, subscribe, and post in the comments to let me know that you like this or you want to see more about Maltego or OSINT or other OSINT techniques, like some Google dorking techniques or different reverse image searches that you can run, different things like that. So if you are interested, definitely let me know in the comments below, and I look forward to seeing you guys in the next video.